Hey, in the video 2 days ago, I showed you how you can build scales on the MIDI keyboard, or better, on the piano roll inside Bitwig Studio, by only just selecting the white keys with a different starting point, or with the black keys with a different starting point. So to recap this, if you start your melody or when you center your melody around a certain key, you are in a certain scale. So if you start at A and center your melody with all the white keys around this key, you are in the key of A minor. If you start at C and use all the white keys on the keyboard, you are in C major. So just by choosing a different starting point for your scale or root note, you are in a different scale or mode. So this is not only pretty nice to create melodies inside the piano roll, this is also nice when you try to play actually the piano for yourself with your hands. And if you can't play piano, then you have multiple problems, of course. Not only that you don't know which key to press, you also have the problem to press it fast enough and to change your finger positions. And yeah, and think about what you're pressing next, right? So this is basically to solve one problem, which key to press. So when you have A minor and you start with A here, and then you only have to think about which key to press next. So in this case, I just choose randomly some white key. Sounds okay, and you are in A minor. Just have to repeat the pattern so it sounds like a melody, and you have to start or to end the melody on A, so you are on A minor. You also can do this with the black keys, and when you start at D sharp here and use all the black keys, you are in D sharp pentatonic minor. So this is great to create maybe melody lines, because you have only 5 notes to choose from, and to make maybe bass lines. So this is pretty nice for that. So it's pretty easy. You just have to think about the pattern you want to play. Choose all the black keys and only make sure that you start with the special key or center the whole melody around that key by starting or ending at that key. And not only you can minor, so when you start at D sharp you have D minor pentatonic, or when you start at A you have A minor diatonic. You can also start at C, so you have C major, and you only have to make sure that you center your melody around C. So just come up with an idea for a pattern, for a melody pattern, center around the key you want to start in, or which mode you want to start in, and then you can go with that. All you have to do then is maybe train or make daily lessons to get your finger positions more fluidly, or you get faster at playing different patterns. But if you start with the piano, or you have a MIDI keyboard bought just recently, you can use this small trick with the white keys and the black keys to get at least a starting point. The next thing is, of course, when you know this trick, you can also build chords with that. So For example, if you start in A minor, you choose the A, and the first chord of A minor is A minor. And to build minor chord, you have to remember the pattern root key, 1, 2, 3 steps, 3 half steps, 4, 5, 6, 7. And that's the first chord of the A minor scale. It's A minor. And the second chord is just by choosing as a starting point the second second note of the first chord. So this, and then you build the next chord from that. 1, 2, 3. Black is not in the scale because it's a black key. So you choose this one. It's 4, 5, 6, 7. And you have the next chord. So you can basically come to every solution just by looking at your keyboard, starting at A, choosing all the white keys on the keyboard. You are in the scale of A minor. The first chord of A minor is A minor. So root note 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You can come to the first chord just by looking at the keyboard. I mean, using also only the white keys. Then you try to build the second chord by choosing just the second note as a starting point, and then you try to count again. 1, 2, 3. So that's not possible. So we take 4, which is a major key, a major chord. 5, 6, 7. So we have a major chord, and we have in the first one a minor chord. All minor chords have the sequence 0, 3, 7. And all major chords have 0, 4, 7. That's a major chord. But this major chord is not in the scale of A minor because we have this black key here. So it's a minor chord. And you go up until you are on the next octave with A. And you can build your chords from that. I mean, it takes some time, but when you do it again and again, you remember certain chords and positions on the keyboard, and you can play it just from your memory. So what is now when you want to play another scale, for example, G minor? You can play A minor, which is A in all white keys, but G minor is a bit different, right? There are some black keys inside the scale, but you don't know it. You have to look up in the internet or in a textbook which keys you have to press to be in G minor. And you can do this, or you can build this from inside Bitwig with a tool. And you just use A and all white keys to play A minor, and you choose to use the pitch shifter and pitch everything down 1, 2 semitones. 1, 2. So you are now on G. When you play A, you are actually on a G. Okay? So you can play A minor with all the white keys, but you are in G minor. So you just by playing A minor, you are in G minor. And you can repeat that for all keys. So if you want to play in A minor and go up 2 semitones or 3 semitones, 1, 2, 3, then you're playing C minor. So this is C minor, but we are playing on the keyboard A minor. This is a trick I sometimes use when I don't know the keys for a certain scale and mode. So what that means is, if you can play A minor, you can play all minor scales on the keyboard with the note pitch shifter as a helping tool. Okay. If you can play C major, which is C in all white keys on the keyboard, with the help of the note pitch shifter, you can play all major scales on the keyboard. And this is a pretty handy tool, or helpful advice to do that. Maybe not to learn the actually keys for the certain scales, but if you are in a hurry and you don't know which keys to press, this is the way to go. The same method applies to when you use the pentatonic scale. So here, in this case, D sharp minor pentatonic. And you want, instead of D sharp, you want to have as a root note G. Then you go up 1, 2, 3, 4 semitones. And now we are playing in G minor pentatonic. So just by transposing the scales around, you are landing on a different scale. So all you need to know is which mode you are actually playing in. So if you are in minor, all white keys, or C major, and you can transpose everything around to a different root key. I hope I got this point across what I wanted to say. I know I repeated myself a whole lot, but I actually saw that a lot of people tend to ask me questions what I already explained in the video, but I wanted to make this very clear. This is basically easy stuff to remember in your brain. I think that's everything I wanted to tell you in this video. Maybe I do another video when people ask questions about certain stuff, but I think that's it for now. Maybe I can explain some things about chords, but maybe it's too much for this video. Maybe I do another one. So thank you for watching, and I see you in the next one. Bye.